once again to Daily Manna, our featured broadcast that we bring to you each and every day by way of this platform. And it's designed to help you to feed your faith and starve your doubts. I'm just honored that we're able to do it through Facebook Live as well as through YouTube, sharing with you some nuggets of God's Word, and to pray that you're being blessed through and by it. We're now on this beautiful day that we call Friday, and we're excited that we're studying God's Word. Just want to remind you, this upcoming Sunday, we are going to have our welcome back service, and we're excited that Bishop Green is going to be with us at the 7:30 hour, and we're also overwhelmingly blessed that at 4 o'clock, we're going to be blessed to have Pastor Eddie D. Smith from the Macedonia Baptist Church in Macon, Georgia. It's going to be a great time, and we want to encourage you to come and be a part of us. We're inside of verse number 7 and going to verse through verse 10, inside of God's Word, and want you to look carefully at God's Word. It says, what then? What Israel sought so earnestly, it did not obtain, but the elect did. The others were hardened, as it is written. God gave them a spirit of stupor, eyes so they could not see and ears so they could not hear to this very day. And David says, may their table become a snare and a trap, a stumbling block and a retribution for them. May their eyes be darkened so they cannot see and their backs be bent forever. Those verses really calls one to just scratch your head and be in a position where you start really laboring and being concerned and being almost thrown off. Because what the text implies is that there are some people that ultimately are so set in their ways and can become so set that they prevent their own redemption. Even more so, that which is scary is they can become so set in their ways that the text says they were hardened, implying somebody hardened them. Someone made it a point for them not to change. Now, I need you to hear that, because it's a painful reality for Paul, or for me to accept, and for Paul to therefore deal with, that God put some people in a position where they will never repent. They will never turn back to God through Jesus Christ. They will continue the path because they have so hardened and so set in their ways, they can't turn around. There's some people that ain't gonna never change. And that's hard for me to say for the person who is the pastor who believes that through God, everybody can experience redemption. And I still believe it, and I'm not going to walk away from it. But this text causes me to struggle, because it shows the God who can harden. And the text comes back and confirms what I'm saying. And it says God gave them a spirit of stupor. Okay? He gave them eyes so they could not see and ears so they could not hear. That's what the text says. And that's found inside of Deuteronomy chapter 29, verse 4, and Isaiah chapter 29, verse number 10, that the God that we serve allowed them to be in a position where they could not recognize, could not interpret, could not rationalize. Stupor was what Paul calls them. And even more so, they could have eyes, but they couldn't see, and ears, they could not hear. God did that to them. He allowed them not to be able to process, comprehend. He blocked them from their ability to hear. Thus, because they were not able to hear, they never believed. And because they never believed, they never called on the name of the Lord. Now, you got to always have in your mind this verse when you hear me walk through this as we're going through this Paul's words. The Bible says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. All right? Now that needs to be in your mind. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And yet God is working meticulously at sometimes for some people to never be able to call on the name because they refuse to hear it. And by them not being able to hear it, they never believed in it because it was never deposited. The deposit was not made, so they had no reason to call on it because they did not believe. They did not affirm. They did not grasp hold to. They were not in tune with this name. As a result, they missed the mark. They have not measured up. They have fallen short. But those of us who find ourselves being able to be privileged to say, Jesus, those of us who are privileged to be able to be and say, thank you, Jesus, or glory to God, hallelujah. That means that we have been granted the opportunity to have access into him and know that through the calling and pronouncing and the belief in that name, salvation is granted to each one of us. I am saved because I know the name. Jesus. Yeah, you know, that's the name. And because I know the name, it draws me. It allows me to be transformed. It allows me to be able to transition into what God would have me to be. But according to the scripture, God has hardened. God has blinded. God has deafened. So they have not yet been able to call on that name. Now take your mind back very quickly, and I promise to move on to the next part of our subject matter. If you remember, Moses, in going in and out of the area of the presence of Pharaoh experienced something similar. Every time that Moses went into Pharaoh, after encountering Moses, he would be willing to let the children of Israel go, only for him to get out of the Pharaoh's presence, and God, the text says, God hardened his heart. And God did that continuously almost 9+ times until we got to the 10th plague. And after the 10th plague, he let them go and they marched out only for his heart to get hardened again. And he goes after them and his army drowns in the Red Sea. God stiffened him. And the God, according to the scripture says that God told Moses that was going to be the plan because God wanted the children of Israel to be delivered from the hand of the Egyptians and for them never to see them ever again. Ultimately, God had a plan and a purpose as to how to eliminate the fear of what was behind them. Now, I need y'all to hear that because sometimes we are afraid of what's behind us. But when God fully sets you free, he delivers you from what's behind you. And some of us ought to go ahead and shout and thank God even right now that God has delivered you from what was coming behind you. What behind you got drowned in the sea. And consequently, you can move forward into the new opportunities because every enemy of your past has got drowned. To God be praised. Now, children of God, the Bible goes a tad further to say that the other problem for our humanity and our human existence has been success. Huh? Where you see that at? Do you not see that according to the text talks about their table has become their trap, a stumbling block and a retribution for them, and their eyes have been darkened and they can't see and their backs will be bent forever. What has happened? What has happened is people have allowed stuff to therefore be their block or their inhibitor because of what's on the table, because of what they're able to serve from the table and what they eat from that table has caused for them to be in a position where that's their quest, that's their objective. This is what you want. These are the things you seek for. This is what you are desirous of. And consequently, it has become your stumbling block and your retribution because you therefore allowed your stomach and your eye to be the only things of importance for who you are and what you are going to become. And the very substance of what God intends for you to be cannot be materialized because you're always either running behind what appeases your eye or satisfying the very gluttonous attitudes of your stomach. Now what God says, thus you are now dark and you can't see his ways. You can't see, or you've gotten to the place where you have worked yourself to a frenzy where your back is now bent, where you now become the servant of the very thing you're trying your best to satisfy yourself with. Have you become a servant to your stomach? Have you become a servant to the things that have become your quest that you're so running behind stuff that you're serving it instead of serving the Lord? And you are bent over in your service because you have not been true to the wonderful living and true God. Well, children of God, I want you to hear me tell you that Paul has really done a good job in trying to convey to us a new sense, a new appreciation, a new confidence into who God is, how God operates, and to show us how our rejection has been either because of our stomach or primarily because we have found ourselves being blinded by God himself. We have not been able to come to God either through God's prevention or our prevention. And I want you to begin praying even now that God will save you and save your family. And I want to thank God for a praying grandmama who knew the Lord enough so that I could be able to call on his name and to know him in the free pardoning of my sins. I'm glad for Amy Taylor. Thank God for you, Granny. I'm where I am because of you. Trust me, children of God, I'm out of time, but never out of word. But children, I look forward to coming back together real soon. Until then, I love you and God bless.